The very first mammoths descended from the ancient elephants, around 6 million years ago, in South and East Africa. Just like their ancestors, Mammuthus subplanifrons were hairless and used their trunk and tusks for manipulating objects, fighting, and foraging. The bulls lived solitary lives or formed loose groups, whilst the females were living in herds headed by a matriarch. A female gave birth to a single calf, after a gestation period of almost 2 years. But, unlike their ancestors, these first mammoths started to develop higher and shorter skulls, to accommodate longer crowns of the teeth. They had spirally, twisting tusks, a unique characteristic of the mammoths. And they were big. They were 3.7 meters or 12.1 feet tall at the shoulder and weighed about 9 tons. After 3 million years, their descendants, Mammuthus rumanus, spread across Eurasia, from Britain to China. They inhabited open environments and consumed browse, high-growing woody plants, such as shrubs. Some 700,000 years later, they were replaced by the southern mammoths. They were mixed feeders, consuming both grass and browse. They lived in a time of mild climate, and some populations even inhabited woodlands. They had even shorter and taller skulls and mandibles. Their body was broad and the back was noticeably sloped. The males were 4 meters or 13.1 feet tall and weighed 11 tons. Like the elephants, the females were considerably smaller. Within another 700,000 years, Homo erectus, archaic humans, started to scavenge and butcher mammoths. Around this time, the steppe mammoth evolved in East Asia. Unlike their ancestors, these mammoths were grazers, feeding on low-growing plants. Due to the cold climates they inhabited, they bore a thin coat of fur. They were the largest mammoths ever, with males up to 4.5 meters or 14.8 feet tall at the shoulders, and about 14 tons in weight. The skull was high-domed and short, and bore large twisted tusks. 300,000 years later, a population of mammoths that had entered North America evolved into the Columbian mammoth. They were just as massive as their ancestors, and had red-orange hair. Within 800,000 years, the steppe mammoth populations replaced their ancestors in Europe. After 300,000 years, the woolly mammoths descended from the steppe mammoths in Siberia. They had long, curved tusks. They were considerably smaller than their ancestors, at roughly the same size as African elephants. Males reached 3.5 meters, or 11.5 feet shoulder height, and weighed up to 8 tons. They evolved to have even denser fur and were well adapted to the cold environment of the last ice ages. The color of the coat varied from dark to light. The ears and tail were short to minimize frostbite and heat loss. Fat enabled it to store large amounts of nutrients necessary for survival in temperatures as low as minus 50 degrees Celsius, minus 58 degrees Fahrenheit. Individuals could even live for 60 years. The diet of these mammoths was mainly grasses and sedges. They lived in open grassland biomes. The cool steppe tundra of the northern hemisphere was the ideal place for them to thrive because of the resources it supplied. Within 200,000 years, around the start of the penultimate glacial period, after temperatures began to drop, the woolly mammoths replaced the remaining steppe mammoths in Europe. 100,000 years later, in the beginning of the last ice age, they entered North America by crossing the Bering Strait. Their habitat now covered all the mammoth steppe, which stretched across northern Eurasia and North America. Meanwhile, Mammuthus lamarmorai evolved from surviving steppe mammoths on the island of Sardinia in the Mediterranean. They were dwarf mammoths, with a shoulder height of just 1.4 meters or 4.6 feet. After 40,000 years, in the northern Channel Islands off the coast of North America, the pygmy mammoth, another dwarf mammoth, descended from the Columbian mammoth. They evolved to be less than half the size of their mainland ancestors, at only 2 meters or 6.6 feet tall at the shoulders and 1.3 tons in weight. Later, modern humans, who just arrived in Europe, started to hunt these giants. They used their bones to build dwellings and tools, and depicted them in works of art. Within just 5,000 years, all dwarf mammoths in Sardinia died out. 25,000 years later, during the pronounced warming at the end of the last ice age, the range of the woolly mammoth began to contract, caused by human hunting and the expansion of forests, which were unfavorable habitats. Forests replaced open woodlands and grasslands across the continent. The mammoth steppe, with rich herb and grass vegetation, disappeared. Within only 3,000 years, most in Eurasia and North America died out, as part of a mass extinction of megafauna. The last of them were confined to the northernmost regions of Siberia. Just 1,000 years later, all pygmy mammoths in the Channel Islands died out. Humans hunted the remaining populations to extinction. Within another 1,000 years, almost all woolly mammoths disappeared. Small populations survived on St. Paul Island and Yukon in Alaska, and very few other places, for 4,300 more years. But after another 1,700 years, the very last woolly giants of Tamer Peninsula and Wrangel Island on the northern coast of Siberia died out. All the mammoths are now extinct. Thank you for traveling back in time with us on this historical journey. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, leave a comment and select all notifications for more awesome videos. Until we meet again, keep exploring the past to understand the present and even foresee the future.